So Dogabofa, it's Monday
morning.
We are at the university.
Fujian Catholic University.
I think the training program calls for some agility training.
Yeah, we're not sure. They're warming up.
So this is a morning session right now. Strengthen the core, the glutes, all the smaller muscles. Do some agility training.
Wait, what? Where are the bars? The plates? Was this a jazzercise class? Let's see what Kuo has to say about the reasoning behind all this rehab work.
可是其实从17年到去年卡达，其实我的膝盖一直都是在痛的情况下来做这个训练跟比赛，这样。 对，我在17年世锦赛前一个月去美国先异地训练，就在训练在比赛前两个礼拜就用到，然后就肿超大的，然后是因为就是一直很积极的去贴消肿啊，去做一些肌力训练，然后才能让我在17年世锦赛可以很正常的下去比赛，所以我现在会比较着重在一些小肌群的。 训练就会由体能训练师这边来去开一些课表来加强它，这样。嗯。Fair
enough, Kuo. Admittedly, the morning training was easily as intense as the afternoon sessions. The workout involved doing each of the exercises seen here for at least 3 or 4 sets of anywhere from 8 to 12 or more repetitions. None of this training was easy or could be phoned in. As Gregor demonstrates here.
Whoa!
And it didn't end there. There was also extensive core training. Keep that in mind the next time you're rushing through your accessory work while distractedly scrolling through Instagram. Which is not to say Kuo wasn't above having a little fun every so often during the training. At the end of the session, Kuo's physio did some light massage on her after a cool-down phase.
Trying to fix Gregor's ankles. Is this the worst ankle mobility you've ever seen?
Yes.
No hesitation. Yep. No hesitation.
Yes. So finishing up, this was probably a 2.5-hour session. I think now it's time to get some lunch and then get ready for the afternoon session.
We go to eat the traditional Taiwan food.
After training, we're getting treated with some traditional Taiwanese food, and everything's looking really good. I just said, whatever you want, I'll try. I'll probably be very happy with it. So, yeah.
Same day, Monday afternoon, and what are we about to see?
Hsing-Chun has her afternoon session. Coach said snatch and clean and jerk, and usually it's a heavy day.
Fingers crossed. But now they started the warm-up. I think I should go for it. See how that goes.
一开始训练的时候，一开始就是先拿木棍嘛，练一些技术动作。对，然后一开始其实我非常排斥举重，我非常讨厌举重。那时候还是比较喜欢篮球跟田径。But
fate had other plans for Kuo.
那时候我们练得很勤，因为团队项目嘛，所以我们那时候其实是非常有希望在全州运拿下奖牌的。 棒一出去的时候，哇，我觉得跑超快的，我觉得跑超快，而且就是真的哦，这个速度，我觉得我们一定可以晋级这样。所以，当我交给我同学的时候，他的手这样一拍出来的时候，我的棒子刚好这样打到他的手，他棒子就这样，这时候就慢动作了。啊，对，然后当然当下我就是马上捡起来就借给他，但我们还是有跑完，对，所以那时候我就在厕所。 我就在厕所大哭，我就讲我不要练田径了，这样子，对，所以就非常的难过。然后就隔一天，我在举重场上拿了金牌。
Kuo wasn't fully sold on weightlifting just yet, But a simple misunderstanding kept her in the sport.
那时候就是我在讨厌举重，然后连学校都不去的那段时间，所以我连篮球跟田径都被退队了。可是那时候我就很，就是一直很想要回去跟队友一起训练、一起比赛的那个生活，所以我就请我的队友去帮我求情，跟教练说能不能让我回到队上跟大家一起奋斗。然后那时候教练就说：“好，如果你要练田径，你举重就要跟着练。”可是这句话其实一直到2016还17年，我们在聊天的过程中，我才发现说，原来他那个时候的意思是举重跟田径你选一项。然后就我听成说，如果你要练举重，只要练人要练田径，你举重就要跟着练。所以就因为这样的听错，所以才能够一直持续我在举重这条路上的。应该说一个才能够让我可以一直在举重这条路上啊。
Much like how Dimas was caught stealing fruit by his future weightlifting coach, for Kuo, a simple turn of fate had a profound and lasting impact on her life.
我觉得，哎，没有到喜欢，哎，没有啦。我觉得就是可以从练举重这个部分去发掘他，我可以用另外一种方式，就像我希望他可以举得很轻松这样的方式来去喜欢他，然后加上说他举重对我来说，举重是可以算是翻转我人生的这个一个项目，然后他不仅仅是改变了我的人生，也改变了我整个家庭的人生，然后当然我也需要靠举重来去支撑我的家庭，然后也可以靠着举重，然后让自己成为有，可以让我成为有，就是有影响力的人，然后去影响更多学弟学妹啊，然后也可以去帮助更多更多需要帮助的人，这样子。
That night, Coach Lin treated us to the first of many meals involving a vast assortment of dumplings.
Hey, order. Hey, you say curry? What kind of vegetable? Number one.
Oh my god.
You got to eat it. Yeah. Here we are.
The dumpling feast was followed up by a particular local delicacy, a kind of Taiwanese no-dos, you might say.
Pinang, very, very famous. I show you, and then follow me. Okay. Okay. Go ahead. Not eat. So many workers, driver need this. If you're tired, at least
I wanted to go to sleep tonight.
Nah. Oh shit. So many people every day need this. Just like you need cold coffee. I need tea. Same. Like a drop. Yeah.
Coming up next time.
Coach, where are we right now?
Leohe Night Market.
Thank you.